Do you prefer this or this? Want to impress your friends like a pro by identifying aircraft? Keep watching this video until the end to hone your skills and showcase your ability to recognize different planes. Welcome to Aviation Showdown, where we compare two of the most iconic giants of the sky, the Airbus A350 and the Boeing 777. Get ready to embark on a journey through history, specifications, and everything in between as we delve deep into the what makes these aircraft true marvel of modern engineering. From their passenger capacities to their fuel efficiency, they leave no stone unturned in this comprehensive comparison. So sit back, relax, and prepare for an exhilarating exploration of aviation excellence. The Boeing 777 emerged from the ambitious vision of Boeing in the 1990s, destined to redefine the concept of long-haul travel. From its inception, the 777 set itself apart as a pioneering model, raising bar for comfort, reliability, and range. As it soared through the skies, the 777 solidified its status as the undisputed ruler of the long-distance flight realm, earning the admiration of passengers and pilots alike. Meanwhile, the Airbus A350, a great example of European smarts and engineering, first flew in 2013. It marked a big step forward in how planes are made and how well they work. People everywhere were impressed by its cool design and how well it flew. The Boeing 777 has several variants, including the original 777-200, the longer-range 777-300, and the newest 777X series with advanced features like folding wingtips. The Airbus A350 comes in two main variants, Airbus 350-900 for efficiency and the larger Airbus 350-1000 for higher capacity. Both families are tailored for long-haul flights with different focuses on capacity and technology. Now, let's step into the heart of these magnificent machines, the cockpit. The Airbus A350 cockpit design embodies the epitome of modernity and ergonomics. Pilots are greeted by a spacious and intuitively laid out workspace, featuring state-of-the-art avionics and fly-by-wire technology, with digital displays providing comprehensive flight information and intuitive controls at their fingertips. Pilots aboard the Airbus 350 experience unparalleled situational awareness and control. Meanwhile, the Boeing 777 cockpit exudes a timeless elegance combined with cutting-edge functionality. Pilots are greeted by a classic layout enhanced with modern avionics, offering a seamless blend of tradition and innovation. From the iconic Boeing control yokes to the intuitive glass cockpit displays. How about the engines? The 777 variants are powered by engines from three major manufacturers: General Electric GE90, Pratt & Whitney PW4000, or Rolls-Royce Trent 800. The GE90 engines on the 777-300ER variant, for example, is one of the most powerful jet engines in the commercial service, with a thrust range of 110,000 to 115,300 pounds force. The GE9X engine, which powers the newest 777X variant, pushes the boundaries further with a thrust of 110,000 pounds force, a front fan diameter of 134 inches, and an overall pressure ratio of 60. The Airbus 350 family is exclusively powered by Rolls-Royce Trent XWB engines. The Trent XWB-84 engine used on the Airbus A350-900 variant provides a takeoff thrust of 84,000 pounds, while the Trent XWB-97 for the Airbus 350-100,000, while the Trent XWB-97 for the Airbus 350-1000 variants offer 97,000 pounds of thrust. These engines are noted for their high efficiency, with the Trent XWB being the world's most efficient large aero engine in operation today. Both aircraft use engines that are marvels of modern engineering, designed to provide the power needed for long-haul flights while optimizing fuel efficiency and reducing emissions. The choice of engine reflects the aircraft mission profile. With the 777's GE90 and GE9X engines focusing on high thrust and payload capabilities, and the Airbus A350 Trent XWB engines emphasizing efficiency and environmental sustainability. The Boeing 777X is the largest twin-engine aircraft ever built. Of course, Airbus is credited with the world's largest passenger aircraft, the Airbus 380, but the quad-jet era is slowly coming to an end. If you're curious about the reasons behind the Airbus 380 failure, I recommend watching this video. The Airbus 350 is currently the European manufacturer's largest wide-body aircraft since the Super Jumbo program was discontinued. When comparing the size of the two twin jets, Boeing will dominate in terms of capacity. The larger 777-9 offers a typical two-class capacity of 426 seats. This compares with 369 for Airbus 350-1000. The 777-8 will be in a similar league as the 1000, with a capacity of around 390. The smaller A350-900 offers 300. The smaller A350-900 offers 315 seats in a typical two-class configuration. On the cargo side, the Airbus widebody can take a payload of 68 tons, accommodating up to 44 LD3 containers. On the other hand, Boeing 777X can take 48 LD3 containers. The 777X, as you would expect, is physically large as well. The 777-9 measures 76 meters in length, while the Airbus 350-1000 has an overall length of 73 meters. The 777X also has a much larger wingspan, measuring 71 meters when extended and 64 meters on the ground. Without folding wingtip technology, the Airbus 350-1000 has a wingspan of 64 meters. The 777-8 will be larger than planned after Boeing decided to stretch the variant's fuselage by 3.5 feet, boosting its capacity from 384 to 395. Along with a slight increase in range from 8730 nautical miles to 8745 nautical miles. Although Airbus has pondered whether to launch a stretched version of the Airbus 350-1000, it has apparently decided against this. Now let's talk about cabin configuration. The Airbus A350 and Boeing 777s offer distinctive cabin experiences, reflecting their respective design philosophies. The Airbus 350 cabins, part of aerospace family, is designed with passenger well-being in mind, featuring award-winning ambient lighting, larger windows for natural light, and a quieter environment, which together contribute to minimize jet lag. The cabin's cross-section is optimized for comfort, allowing more personal space and flexible seating configuration. In contrast, the Boeing 777's cabin is known for its spacious and sky interior philosophy, which integrates visual aspects like architecture and lighting with advanced technologies for pressurization, air filtration, and humidity control, aiming to create cohesive passenger experience. While both aircraft provide high level of comfort, the Airbus 350 focuses on a modern, holistic travel experience, and 777 emphasizes a harmonious blend of comfort and technology. Both aircraft offer range suitable for the longest standard long-haul flights. The Airbus 350-1000 does beat the 777-9 here with a maximum range of 16,000 km. The 777-9 offers slightly less at 13,500 km. The smaller 777-8, though, will shake things up. According to the figures published by the Boeing, it offers a range of 16,000 km. Boeing claims the new 777X will also be world's most efficient widebody aircraft, thanks to its innovative aerodynamics and engines. However, it is hard to compare efficiency until the aircraft has entered service. Furthermore, the two jets are pretty different here. The Airbus 350 is a clean sheet design with composite constructions, while the 777X sticks with the aluminum fuselage of the Boeing 777 but uses composite materials on its wings. In the wide body aircraft market, the Airbus A350 has a 42% share with 38 orders, while the Boeing 777's new 777-8F variant has 58 orders. Airbus aims to produce 6 Airbus 350 monthly by autumn 2022, having made 609 so far. Boeing has delivered 1,072 7 of 2,268 orders 777S, with high anticipation for the upcoming 777X. This competition highlights the strong market demands for both models. The Boeing 777X models are pricier, with the 777-9 at $442 million and 777-8 at $410 million. Compared to the Airbus A350 models priced lower, with the Airbus 350-1000 at $366 million and the Airbus 350-900 at $317 million. Although discounts are common, the 777X larger capacity comes at a higher cost. Now let's have a glimpse of these modern wide bodies head-to-head in raw numbers. I invite you to share your personal experiences flying aboard either of these remarkable aircraft in the comments below. And now for the grand finale, spotting these giants in the wild. A Boeing 777-200 has just 4 doors on each side of the aircraft. Meanwhile, the 777-300 has 5 doors on each side of the aircraft. The Airbus A350 cockpit windows has 6 curved cockpit windows with rounded corners, while you can compare it with 777 in the image. The Airbus A350 nose shape is similar to the Boeing 787, but the Airbus 350 nose is more rounded. But the Boeing 777 nose shape is similar to the 767, but with a larger diameter. The Airbus A350 winglets are more curved winglets. While Boeing 777 variants have standard wingtips, but these variants have raked wingtips. Airbus A350 main landing gear for the -900 has 4 wheels per leg, while the Airbus 350-1000 has 6 wheels per leg. In the other hand, 777 main landing gear 6 wheels per leg, which tilts backward when not under load. Airbus A350 vertical stabilizer, the leading edge meets the fuselage with a very small curve, and there is no dorsal fin. During the final step, there have been more controversies surrounding these beauties. The Airbus A350 and Boeing 777 have both faced their share of controversies. The Airbus A350 has been subject to concern regarding its composite structure, engine reliability and production delays, with Airbus actively working to address these issues. Additionally, a notable dispute involved Qatar Airways grounding part of its Airbus 350 fleet over surface paint degradation. On the other hand, the Boeing 777 has faced a scrutiny over manufacturing practices, with whistleblower allegations suggesting that safety and quality concerns were dismissed during production, particularly in the 787 and 777 jets. These controversies highlight the challenges and complexities inherent in the aerospace industry. Until next time, happy flying with Aviation by Ellie.